Yes, good morning, beta. In the last class, we were discussing exercise 10.5 until question number 6. Question, I think we were doing. Okay, we haven't completed that question, so let's complete question number 6 first. In question number 6, you have given a cyclic quadrilateral whose name is A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is a cyclic quadrilateral. Yes, A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. This angle is 70. And DBC is 70. Wait. हमने उसे नेम डिफरेंट वे में दिए थे. A, B, C, D. DBC is 70. Angle BAC is 30. We want to find BCD. Actually, in the last class, we have started this question and we have given the name in this order. So if I change the order, then you all have to draw the figure again. So I have changed the name according to the last class. This angle is 70. You have to find angle BCD. This angle we need to find. As you know that it is a cyclic quadrilateral. So if I find this angle, then the sum of these opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral is 180. Then you can easily find this angle BCD. So for this, we need this angle. Can you see that arc DC subtend this angle here, and the same arc is subtending angle this 70 degree here. So angle in the same segment are always equal. Is there any hairy in 9th B? So, solution, angles in the same segment are equal. So this implies angle DAC is equal to DBC is equal to 70. So this angle we have got as 70. So can we say that angle A is 70 plus 30, that is 100, as ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral. So can we say that sum of A and C is 180? This is 100. So angle C will be your 80 degree. Is it okay? So we have got angle C as 80 degree. C means BCD. C means angle BCD. That's what we want to find here. Now look here, in the second part, if you have given AB is equal to BC, agar AB or BC equal ho jaye here, then what will happen? If these two sides are equal, then find angle ECD. Ye angle find karna hai apne. Theek hai? How you will do it? Ye dekho idhar. It's very easy. Yes, Diya.
Ma'am, it will become an isosceles triangle, and angles equal to opposite to equal sides are also equal.
Yes.
Using angle sum property, we will find the.
No need of angle sum property. ये angle कितना है पूरा? 80. ये angle पूरा कितना है? 80. So 80 में से if you subtract this 30, then you will get this as 50. Okay. Now what you will do, as this is given, then you have to find angle ECD. ECD means this angle you need to find. Then I'm writing the solution here. I'm rubbing this. If I write AB is equal to BC, this implies angle BAC, this angle is equal to BCA. Is equal to 30 degree. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. So an angle BCD is your 80, and BCD can be written as BCA plus ACD. Is it so? Can I write BCD as this complete angle as this plus this? So I have written the name of this BCA and ACD. So sum of these two angles is 80. And this angle BCA is your 30. Then after subtracting, you will get ACD as 50. And ACD means ECD. You can write ACD or you can write ECD, which is same as 50. Is it okay? Any doubt? Now, next question, question number 7. Question number 7 is, if the diagonals of a cyclic quadrilateral are the diameters of the circle, then show that it is a rectangle. Then show that the figure that is formed in a circle is a rectangle. We need to show that the figure inside this is a rectangle. So you will start with the rectangle. Is it okay? A, B, C, and D. Yes, look here. You have given a cyclic quadrilateral. नहीं आपको cyclic नहीं दिया हुआ, आपको ये दिया हुआ है diagonal, cyclic दिया हुआ है. The diagonals of the cyclic quadrilateral are the diameter. कहते हैं एक cyclic quadrilateral है, इसके जो diagonals हैं, वो इसके diameters भी हैं. Diameter मतलब इसके center से pass कर रही हैं, circle के center से pass कर रही हैं. Then show that the figure that is formed in the inside this, that is, wait, inside this quadrilateral, inside this circle is a rectangle. आपके पास क्या क्या गिवन है देखो. एक तो ये गिवन है कि ए बी सी डी जो है वो साइक्लिक है. दूसरा क्या गिवन है, ए बी ए सी, ए सी और बी डी जो है वो क्या है, डायमीटर्स. ये दोनों क्या गिवन है, डायमीटर्स गिवन है. As you know that in case of a circle, the diameter divide the circle into two equal part. और अगर यहाँ पे कोई angle बनता है तो angle in a semicircle is always a right angle. ठीक है, तो same way में अगर BD diameter है तो ये angle क्या होगा, 90. ये angle क्या होगा, 90. And in the same way, if AC will act as a diameter, this angle and this angle both will be 90-90 again. Got it? So these two things are given to prove. What we want to prove here is A, B, C, D is a rectangle. What do you mean by rectangle? What do you need to show? A parallelogram with one angle 90 is a rectangle. A parallelogram with one angle 90 is a rectangle. So आपने इसको parallelogram show करना है. Now in the proof, what you will write? If BD is diameter, this implies angle A equal to angle C 90. This if यहाँ पे मैं दोनों इकट्ठे लिख दूँ, दो बार लिखना पड़ेगा. If BD and AC are diameters, आप चाहो तो separate भी लिख सकते हो. Are diameter, then A and C is 90 and B and D are also 90. Angles in a semicircle is 90 degree. Angle in a semicircle is 90 degree. तो ये 90 आ गया आपके पास. ठीक है, अब देखो इधर. We need to show that it is a rectangle. A parallelogram with one angle 90 is a rectangle. एंगल तो 90 हो गई, बट रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग इज यू हैव टू शो दैट इट इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. डिड यू रिमेंबर अबाउट द थ्योरम दैट यू हैव डिस्कस्ड इन चैप्टर नंबर 8, क्वाड्रिलेटरल. इफ द ईच पेयर ऑफ ऑपोजिट एंगल ऑफ अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल इज इक्वल या आर इक्वल, देन इट इज अ पैरेललोग्राम. दिस थ्योरम इज गिवन इन द क्वाड्रिलेटरल चैप्टर. आई कैन टेल यू द पेज नंबर ऑल्सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी दिस रिजल्ट. वेट, लेट मी टेल यू द पेज नंबर. Page number 140, theorem number 8.5. Page number 180, theorem number 8.5. If in a quadrilateral each pair of opposite angle is equal, then it is a parallelogram. So you can write this result. Otherwise, we have a long method to solve, but better to go for this method that will reduce the length of the solution. If in a quadrilateral each pair of opposite angles is equal, then it is a parallelogram. So can we say that ABCD is a parallelogram with one angle 90? This implies ABCD is a rectangle. Is it okay? Read out question number 9. That is very, very easy. Hurry up. You please all try to find out the solution of that. I'm waiting. Yes, anyone who have got the solution of ninth question, you can, who can tell me how to will, how you will solve this? एट्थ क्वेश्चन अभी करते हैं, पहले नाइन्थ कर रहे हैं हम, एट्थ भी कर लेते हैं, थोड़ा बड़ा है, ठीक है अभी करते हैं नाइन्थ। देखो जरा, P A C Q B D, look here, listen to me, two circles intersect each other at B and C, those circles hain, they are intersecting at the two points, the line segment ABD, this line, and PBQ, this line, are drawn to intersect the circle at the point AD, PQ, four points pe cut kar rahi hain, do circle ko. Prove that ACP, ACP means this angle, and QCD, these two angles are equal. We need to show that. Yes, look here. It's very easy. Can you see that this arc is making angle this and this, angle one and angle two. Given and to prove, I will write later on. Proof I am writing side by side. Arc AP makes angle one and angle two. So angle one is equal to angle two. Angles in a same segment are equal. In the same way, this arc BQ is making angle 3 and 4, arc DQ is arc BQ makes angle 3 and 4, so angle 3 is equal to angle 4, same reason. Now can you see that these two lines are intersecting each other, so angle 1 and angle 3 are vertically opposite angle. Angle 1 and 3 are vertically opposite angle. 1 2 ke equal hai, 3 4 ke equal hai, ye dono aapas mein equal hai, both of these are equal, so can we say that 2 is equal to 4? So this is your first result, second result, third result, from 1 2 and 3 angle 2 is equal to angle 4, hence proved. Got it? So you please make the figure. given in two proof. You can write for this question at your own. Excuse me. Let's start with question number 8. Question number 8. In question number 8, you have given, if the two non-parallel sides of the trapezium are equal, ये ट्रेपीजियम है, ट्रेपीजियम इज गिवन ए बी सी डी, दीज आर द टू पैरेलल साइड्स, ए बी इज पैरेलल टू सी डी, ये गिवन है, एंड द नॉन पैरेलल साइड्स ए डी इज इक्वल टू बी सी, ये आपको गिवन है, ठीक है, आपने शो करना है, क्या शो करना है, A, B, C, D is cyclic. What do you need for the cyclic? If you make this, that the sum of the either pair of opposite angle is 180, then it will be cyclic. So that is angle A plus C equal to 180 or B plus D is equal to 180. This we need to show. Got it? Now, look here. What we are doing is we are making the construction. We are making here two perpendiculars from the point A and B. We have drawn the two perpendicular lines AM and BN. Draw AM perpendicular to DC and BN also perpendicular to DC. So you need two perpendiculars from the vertex. Got it? Now, what we are doing is, we will make these two triangles as congruent. So, for the congruency, I will write the name in triangle ADM and triangle BCN. You will show these two triangles as congruent. These two sides are equal. This angle M and N are both 90. M and N are 90 by construction. AD is equal to BC. AD equal to BC. Given, and one thing is AM is equal to BN. Why these two are equal? Because the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides are same. Perpendicular distance between parallel sides same hota hai. So this implies ADM is congruent to BCN. Ye congruent ho gaye. If they are congruent, can we say that what result you will derive from here? We will say that this angle D matlab AD C aur yahan se BC D equal hai by CPCT. Can we say this? These two angles are equal by CPCT. Now it's very easy. अब देखो आगे, यहां देखो दोनों एंगल इक्वल हो गए. अब आपको ये पता है कि ये और इस एंगल का सम क्या है, ए और डी का सम क्या है, 180. क्यों? क्योंकि साइड पैरलर है. सम ऑफ को इंटीरियर, सम ऑफ को इंटीरियर एंगल. अब यहां देखो, ये एंगल किसके इक्वल है, सी के. तो कैन वी रिप्लेस डी बाय सी, इज इट ओके? These two angles are equal ना, base angles equal होते हैं. अगर equal हैं, तो हमने D को replace कर दिया C से, तो आपके पास A और C का सम आ गया 180. In the same manner, can I say that angle B plus C का सम क्या है, 180. ठीक है, और C किसके equal है, D के. तो यहाँ पे C की जगह मैंने क्या लिख दिया, D, because C and D are same. तो अब आपके पास क्या आ गया, sum of either pair of opposite angle is 180, therefore it is a cyclic coordinate. You will write the result. Sum of either pair of opposite angles is 180, therefore it is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore it is a cyclic quadrilateral. Is it okay? Any doubt Hope it is clear to you all.